Okay, so here are some of our Black Friday, Cyber Monday orders. Again, I want to thank all of our supporters during the past few days. Thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you. Hey Rat Fam, welcome back to my channel. I know it's been a few months since I posted my business update video, but I've been mostly creating content for my personal YouTube channel. But I'm back. Today is currently November 29th. It is the day after Cyber Monday, and I'm about to prep my Black Friday and Cyber Monday orders. So I decided to why not vlog it, right? And say hey to everyone. And of course, thank all of my supporters during the past few days for our Black Friday Cyber Monday sale. I already pulled most of the head wraps and ironed them. I did not vlog it, but I did get an order in this morning for three head wraps. So I'm going to prep those with together with the Black Friday Cyber Monday orders, because that's going to go out tomorrow with the orders. So I'll do that a little bit later. Right now I'm going to pull some bonnets. Those are the bonnets behind me. Going to pull some bonnets. We have to pull some scrunchies, headbands, fleece lined scarves. So I'm going to prop you guys up on the tripod so I can be hands-free while I do that. Okay, so here are some of our Black Friday, Cyber Monday orders. Again, I want to thank all of our supporters during the past few days. Thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you. But now I am going to start with my Canadian order. Chantel, she is an existing customer. Thanks, Chantel. And she got a bonnet. I think it's the last one. What size is this? Medium. Oh, I'm pulling a large. This is why you gotta label stuff. And I don't know. That's small. Okay. I think I gotta start digging. Here we go. She got the Remy medium. So I'm gonna place this here on my container of scrunchies. It's not on the floor, it's on my scrunchie right there. One of my scrunchie containers. Okay, and we're just pulling bonnets right now. So I'm just going through and pulling wherever I see bonnets. All right, so we have a Commander Black Satin Large. Here's my large Commander, because I have Commander in orange satin and fuchsia satin. So this person got a large. Put that right there. I don't know if you guys can see. Okay, and this person also got a Jabir large. This is one of my best sellers. Next, we have four bonnets and a headband. So I'm gonna pull her bonnets first. So she has a fawn medium. Medium fawn. She has a Naya small. This is a Naya small. Everything has a size on them. She has a Zoe pink medium. So let's see. Because I have multiple Zoes. I have red, blue, rainbow. But she has a pink. Okay, here it is. The Zoe Pink medium. And another Jabir medium. This time, the other one was a large. Jabir medium. Next, we have another four bonnet order. I don't want to show you her address. Another four bonnet order. And she is an existing customer, Whitney. Thanks, Whitney. Okay, Whitney, you have a Dahlia extra large. So me pull that. The extra large is at the top. This is the extra large Dahlia. Let me turn down the exposure so you guys can see. With a pretty purple satin. This is so pretty. This is the extra large. Super cute. Put that on the bottom since it's the biggest. Okay, she also has a Naya extra large. Oh, I gotta get my stool for this one. It's too high for me. Okay. So I have a stool because I'm short, guys. I'm only 5 feet. All right, so she has a Naya extra large. So pretty. Then she has a Michelle small. This is a Michelle small. So cute. And last, another Dahlia small. It's probably like a matching set. This is the small. Next, we have Janice ordered two bonnets. Thanks, Janice. Janice has a Commander medium fuchsia lining. So that's black, that's orange. Let's see, where is large, small. All right, so it must be down here. Yeah, it's down here. Okay, so this is the medium commander with the fuchsia lining. Very pretty. And she also got a medium Juno blue because I have two colors of Juno. So this is medium Juno blue with the orange satin. Very pretty. All right, next we have this is a mixed order of a headband, head wrap, and a bonnet, but she got Shakira. Thank you, Shakira. Got a jean large with the fuchsia satin. So here is the jean, like a denim, soft denim. And she got a large. Right, next we have, and that's all head wraps. It's head wraps and headbands. friends. Hope I don't skip any of these. If I do, I'll catch it when I'm packing. Next, we have a Animal Instinct small bonnet from Marie. Thanks, Marie. This was also a bestseller. Put my phone down. With the animal print and the black satin. Wait, is it focusing? There we go. Small. Those are scrunchies. Headbands and head wraps. Okay, we have a bonnet, head wrap, headband combo order, but in this order from Elise. Elise is an existing customer. Thanks, Elise. She got a Jabir large bonnet. So again, one of our, this is the most selling bonnet style in the, in our entire bonnet collection is Jabir. Doesn't matter what size, all sizes. I actually had to restock this before Black Friday because all we had was, I think, small or baby or both. Can't remember. Next, we have Guabia. I hope I'm pronouncing it right. This person is an existing customer. Thank you. Sorry if I'm not pronouncing your name right. Guabia. Or Guabea. And she got a combo order of head wraps, headbands, and a bonnet. Jean large black satin. Okay, so we saw the jean pink satin, fuchsia satin. This is the jean black large. All right, let's see. All right, I think that's all for bonnets. So now we're going to pull some scrunchies. Okay, so we have a Aura satin scrunchie, the royal blue. So we have that. Thank you, Rashina. That is the customer. We also have two panther satin scrunchies. So this customer, she got two of these. That is from Shakia. I have to pull her other items later. Thanks, Shakia. Then we have, oh, my girl, Keisha. Keisha got our Denby, like a Kente scrunchie. Keisha also got the light indigo denim scrunchie. Next, we're going to pull some textured knot headbands. And this is for Danielle. Thanks, Danielle. She has a big order. But she also, in her order, she has a Jada. This is really pretty. The camera does no justice. Okay, we also have a Lotus textured knot headband. That's like a fuchsia color. Here it is. This is our Lotus. That is from Cherie. Thanks, Cherie. She also has other items in her order. I think that's it for the textured. But if I forget anything while I'm packing, I will just grab it. On to more headbands. These are our turban headbands. This is our jabir, our popular print. That is from Michelle. And Michelle has four bonnets in her order. Thanks, Michelle, if I didn't thank you before. This next order from Antonia. She's an existing customer. Thanks, Antonia. She has a lot of headbands. All right, so she has a Cleo. A Shaka. Is my Shaka in this bin? I have three bins of headbands. I don't see Shaka. Okay, so she got a Shaka. Okay, so she got a Giza headband. Khaled sold out. She got the last Khaled. This is a popular print too. I have more of this fabric, so I'll restock at some point. Okay, now we're going to pull some fleece line scarves. These are our winter scarves, and we have two fleece types. Here's the Sherpa. And here is the plush. Shakia, she got a Giza Sherpa. This is the Giza print, but she got the Sherpa lining. So it's this one. She also got a Chua plush. And I have three bins of scarves because I have multiple prints and multiple fleece linings. Okay. And this is the last plush. We have Sherpa for the other. So she purchased the last plush.
A little longer than a few minutes later.
Hey y'all, I'm back. I'm about to print my packing slips for all of my orders because I include packing slips in all of my orders. And I always do that first before I prep shipping labels. So I'm going to do that now and then package everything or try to package everything up on this video. If I don't get to your order on this video, I apologize, but I still appreciate you and I appreciate your support. But I'm going to try. I honestly don't think I'm going to get to all of the orders in this video because it's a lot and I'm grateful. And I thank you, thank you, thank you. But I'm not sure. I'll try. Let's see. So I started putting the sleeves on my head wraps. These are my sleeves. Here they are. Yesterday, but I figured since I'm vlogging today, or since I planned on vlogging today, I'll just do the rest of the head wraps today. So I put the sleeves on first and then they go in a poly bag for protection. So let me turn this way. I wanted to chit chat a little bit about Black Friday. Is it just me or is Black Friday like dying? Because yes, this is not my best Black Friday, but I did okay. But I'm on social media and I'm reading comments, you know, on pages and stuff about Black Friday, Black Friday topics. And they talked about how some people were upset about how, you know, the bigger box brand or bigger box companies or popular companies were not having Black Friday deals, you know, how they used to be. So I'm not gonna call out any companies, but I've seen it. It's a known company. And what they did is that they hiked up their retail price and then act like they had this big sale.
Bruh.
And I'm like, that's not a sale. You end up paying the same price, the same retail original price, or even more. And I'm like, that is not cool. Why do companies do that? They don't think a lot of people will notice, but people are waking up. A lot of people are waking up. And I felt so sad because some people were like, they don't participate in Black Friday anymore because companies don't have real Black Friday deals. And I've seen it. I agree. And yeah, not all small businesses can afford to have 50, 60, 70% off deals because maybe it's not feasible. You know, they don't want to take a big hit because they are a small business. But I'm not talking about small businesses. I'm talking about the bigger brands, the bigger name brands, the big box companies. And I felt so bad because a lot of people were like, yeah, I'm not participating in Black Friday anymore. They don't wait for Black Friday. They shop before Black Friday or at the end of the year to get real deals. And then I thought, well, wouldn't companies do the same thing that they do for Black Friday? I don't know. I don't usually shop at the end of the year unless it's something that I really need. But it made me so sad. And I'm not going to pull up the comments because I'm going to expose people. But I'm like, I have good deals. You know, this year I did 50% off. And I do not hike up my prices, you know, and then give you guys a discount. I did 50% off. And then I did final hours on Cyber Monday. I offered free shipping. Free U.S. shipping. And it's not what it used to be. There aren't the true Black Friday deals how it used to be years ago when it was actually a deal you were getting. And I'm going to insert a news clip about that too, about how Black Friday is just not what it used to be. And don't worry, it's about a 2-minute clip, but I felt it. I felt it in my spirit when I watched that clip.
Night before one of the biggest shopping days of the year, and that typically means people waiting in long lines outside of retail stores. But things look different on the eve of Black Friday this year. Fox 2's Mallory Thomas is checking in with shoppers in Chesterfield.
We've been out here for several hours and we've only run into one person. We're in front of Best Buy. They've got the barricades out here, but there's no shoppers. The days of sleeping off your Thanksgiving meal in a tent and waiting in long lines for doorbuster deals are long gone.
I see nothing. I'm surprised. Normally it's wrapped all the way around the building. Today, no one.
Jeremy Pritchett remembers working in retail during the traditional Black Friday, and it wasn't that long ago.
We would get there probably about midnight, get everything set up. We'd let people in early, give them donuts and coffee, you know, to try to slow down the stampede and stuff. And I mean, it was busy, but it was also one of those that was always fun. And I mean, it's kind of gone, it looks like.
Online shopping seems to be the new normal for Black Friday shopping. Somewhere like this, we've got a Walmart, a Macy's, and then we've got a Best Buy further down. It would typically be a hot spot for Black Friday shoppers, but there's no one here.
I think it's a sign of the way the world is going. That, you know, virtual learning, virtual buying, everybody wants to just be able to sit on their couch and order what they want.
The National Retail Federation says more than 160 million people will shop for deals online through Cyber Monday. Jeremy says he shops online too, but standing in front of an empty store brings a little bit of sadness with it.
You miss that relationship. You know, the customers that used to come in, you know, that type of stuff. Now it's a lot of things in the world, it's just a transaction. Nobody has that personal interaction anymore.
We also made our way over to the Chesterfield Premium Outlets, and it looks very similar over there. It's an empty parking lot. Just security is in the parking lot. In Chesterfield, Mallory Thomas, Fox 2 Thomas.
But yeah, people are not waiting on lines. And I get it, the past couple years because of the pandemic, you know, online shopping did increase. And I don't know if that played a role in how Black Friday is this year. You know, I believe online shopping will increase going forward, but the online sales are not coming in like they used to. And that makes me a little sad. And going back to the consumers who I saw commenting about they're no longer participating in Black Friday, or they're not participating in Black Friday because there's no real deals. Like, I get it, because, you know, if I saw regular sales, like 20 and 30, some people are like, 20% off is not a Black Friday deal. 30% off is not a Black Friday deal. Someone even commented and said, if it's not 50% off or more, I'm not shopping. And then that's when that thread started with the big box companies or the bigger companies bumping up their prices and then discounting them. So you end up paying the same price. I hope it gets better, you know, and I'm not saying everyone had a bad, as far as business owners or small businesses. I'm not saying that everyone, because I don't know how everyone else did. I hope everyone had a successful Black Friday, Cyber Monday this year. And if you're a business owner, and if you didn't, keep your head up, keep working, keep grinding, and pray that things will get better. But yeah, comment down below and let me know. Did you shop a lot this Black Friday? Did you say, nah, I'm good, I don't need anything? Or are you waiting to the end of the year? I don't know how end of the year sales are. Because Black Friday used to be the time of the year for the best sales. But some people were saying, oh, I wait to the end of the year, there's better deals on New Year's or around New Year's. Are they? Comment down below and let me know. And did you shop this Black Friday? Where did you do most of your shopping? Online? Did you go to stores? If you went to any stores, were they empty? I mean, like that news clip, I think a lot of places were not as busy, but just makes me a little sad. I just hope online sales will pick up eventually. These bigger companies got to stop trying to be sneaky and greedy and bumping up their prices, because that discourages people. That discourages people from shopping. You know, I wouldn't want to shop when I see that. And there was this other comment. She said she has something in her cart, and she was waiting specifically for Black Friday to get a discount off of it. She says when she went to her cart, the price remained the same, even with the discount. And that's how she figured out that they bumped up that store, that company bumped up their price, and then put a discount on it. These are my leather wraps, bestseller. I'm actually wearing mine. You can see it. Someone else commented that the item that they had in their cart was cheaper the week before Black Friday. They said, how was this cheaper before Black Friday? You know, people are intentionally waiting for Black Friday to get the Black Friday deals, and then to later find out there is no true deal. You're either paying the same retail price or you're paying a little more. And I don't think that's right. I wouldn't even feel right doing that to my consumers. But yeah, I was mostly surprised at the bigger brands not having true Black Friday discounts. Having 25% off, 30% off. Like, really? That's not a Black Friday deal. Then I started realizing and understanding where some people were coming from. You wait till now, like the end of the year, the day after Thanksgiving, or the day of Thanksgiving, the night of Thanksgiving, to get the best deals, unbeatable deals that that company or brand offers. And to not get that is disappointing. Okay, I'm gonna start prepping, packaging some of these orders. I can see Black Friday not being like how it used to be. I mean, unless online sales increase, I mean, that'll help. Because online sales will increase year after year going forward. They will. And if you're a small business owner or entrepreneur, let me know, how was your Black Friday, Cyber Monday? Since I bought it, this is my first order. My customer from Canada. That was my first Black Friday sale on Thanksgiving. And how do you feel Black Friday? This is a general question for all my viewers. How do you feel about Black Friday in the future? Do you think online sales will increase? Do you think consumers will not care for Black Friday, whether online or in the stores? Let me know. I really pray online will pick up. I'm gonna make sure this is the black satin. Is my second order. I'm gonna lay this out in order so that I don't get anything mixed up. This is the black satin large camel bonnet. And then she also had the Naya. This is from Janice. Oh no, she also had Jabir large. Hope everyone still had a successful Black Friday. And if you didn't, don't let that weigh you down. You just work harder, change a few things around in your store, and just keep grinding. Oh, and I got an email from my mom. Black Friday, Cyber Monday. She's checking in on me. She wants to know how everything went and to call her. I'll call her after I finish filming today. The next one is Dawn. Thank you, Dawn. She had four head wraps. I'm just gonna pull them. I got stuff all over me. Head wraps, bonnets, headbands. She got, where's the other one? Right, let me move these. So Dawn got these four head wraps. Gonna have so much of those little plastic. plastic thingies that I pull off the poly bags. So like that. All right, I think I'm just gonna pack as you guys watch me the rest of the orders, or try to get through the rest of the orders. Again, if I can't get through these orders, I still greatly appreciate all the support. Trust me. Okay, so we got Fawn medium. But yeah. Transparent moment. This year has not been a good year for me in sales. This has been the slowest year, sales year for me since I've been in business. It's scary. It really is scary, but can't give up just because you had a bad, you know, few months or bad week doesn't mean to give up. Especially if the business is your baby. Next up is Whitney, and Whitney got 4 bonnets. We'll be right back. Next, we have Danielle. She got quite a bit of things. Thanks, Danielle. Next, we have Rashina, and she purchased our Aura 2XL Satin Scrunchie. How pretty is that? And I forgot to mention that all of our Black Friday Cyber Monday orders get a free gift. I'm including these red socks. I like to include free gifts for Black Friday. I have since I started my business, since my first Black Friday. Next, I have Janice, and Janice purchased two bonnets. Next, we have Shakira, and she purchased a jean large fuchsia. Okay, the next one is actually a gift. Someone ordered this for someone else. It's going to a Leticia and ordered by a Gerard. So thank you, Gerard. And thank you, Leticia, for rocking the Wraps Adorn brand. Okay, next we have Kiki. Thanks, Kiki. All right, so we're starting off with the Panther Leather Stretch Head Wrap, one of our best sellers. And I believe this year, I started including a non-slip grip band with these. I started including these with my satin head wraps, and then I thought I can include these with the leather as well, because sometimes these slip and slide. So, and the price of the head wrap remained the same. I did not bump up the price of the head wrap. I'm actually gonna slide that in the back. So the gift is in the back of the head wrap. Okay, next we have Alicia. I don't know how you pronounce your name, but thank you. She got two Panther leather head wraps. Next we have Mari, and Mari got a small Animal Instinct bonnet. Thank you, Mari. Okay, next we have an order from Keisha. Hey, Keisha, thank you. Keisha is actually the founder of Green Beauty for Us, and I have a bunch of her candles, so go check her out when you can. Okay, next we have Antonia. Thank you, Antonia. She's got a lot of headbands and a head wrap. Okay, next we have Elise. And Elise, thank you, Elise. She got a Jabir large bonnet. Okay, next we have Sherry. Thank you, Sherry. Okay, so she has a Holly Satin Line Retro Headband. Thank you. Okay, next we have Quabia or Quabea. I hope I'm pronouncing your name right. Okay, so this will be the last order that I prep on camera because it is 5 p.m. Eastern Standard Time and I'm hungry. And I'm going to be packing orders for the rest of the night and I need to take a break. I need to take a break and eat something. I just have a lot more orders to prep and I think I have enough for this vlog. So I'm going to do that. I'm going to prep this last order. Again, thank you to everyone that I did not get to prep on camera. Thank you so, so much for the support. All right, so this next order is for Yolanda. Thank you, Yolanda. Hey guys, so like I mentioned in the previous clip, I am wrapping up this vlog. I hope you guys enjoyed it. Thank you so much for watching. Let me know how you feel about Black Friday, you know, in the comments. And I'm tired, y'all. I'm tired and hungry. I'm about to make some food, some dinner. I'm gonna call my mom. And then I'm going to get back to orders. Oh, again, if I didn't get to your order on camera, it doesn't mean that I don't appreciate you. I do appreciate every one of you. It's just that I need to take a break. I need to get some food in my system. I need to drink some water. I didn't drink enough water today. So if I didn't get to your order on camera, I thank you. I thank you. I see you. I appreciate you. I acknowledge you, trust me. So until next time, I'll see you on my next vlog or video. You can achieve anything you want. Don't let nobody say you can't wait.